doing work. Trying to answer comments on YouTube. Same time, doing Snapchat stuff. Trying to keep him asleep. Uh-oh.
When the sun rises, I wake up and chase my dreams. I won't regret when the sun sets, 'cause I live my life like I'm a beast.
The thing I've learned over the years, you can't make everybody happy, and I ain't even gonna try. If you don't like the way I act or the music I use, then don't even waste your time here. Just go find another boring channel to watch. There's a lot of you that like this channel the way it is, and that's the way it's gonna stay. And for you that like it, let's do work, son. Today I wanna work on laying out the fuel system. Gonna fab a couple little things for the regulator and stuff, but before I do that, I wanna show you something. Part of what I want to do is get you guys involved. I want to get you guys involved in the shop somehow, some way. And doing some remodeling in here, I want to kind of spruce it up a little bit. And this idea is going to kind of go hand in hand with the remodeling. So here it is. Basically, I got these whiteboards. They probably won't stay right here. I may move them at some point. But what I want to do is I want you guys to send me like your shop decals or your shop stickers or your club stickers or whatever you got. Whatever you got and you want it up here, I want you to send it to me. So, you can send it to this address right here. Send me your stickers. I'll put them on the board. I'll make sure it gets on the channel. Plain and simple. So actually what I want to do today is I want to mount this regulator permanently. I've just kind of got it sitting here. I like it right here in the center. The fuel lines will actually come in the back, dash 8, run through the fuel rails, come out the front, and then 90 into the regulator, then out the bottom of the regulator, dash 6, back to the tank. The other thing that happened this week was I got some pulleys for the car. I actually put out a snap on Snapchat just saying, hey man, if you guys got any underdrive pulleys for a Mustang, because I kind of want to keep it factory style, factory looking. Anyway, I put out a snap on Snapchat, said, hey, if you guys got any pulleys that you want to get rid of, let me know. And a subscriber to the channel hit me up and said, hey man, I got some pulleys that you can have. I'll send them to you. So appreciate it, Michael. They look great. Aluminum, they match everything. And one thing I had to do was drill a couple holes in it to accept this style water pump. But other than that, perfect.
I gotta earn it. I gotta earn it.
I can't behave.
much finishes up the regulator. It's a pretty easy deal. It took me about an hour and a half, but kind of brings me to a point that I want to address with a lot of you guys. I know a lot of you guys think that you have to have like the best tools, the best welder, all this fancy stuff to do good fabrication or to do good work. And it's not necessarily true. What makes you look good is the attention to detail. You want people to admire your work? You don't have to like build big fancy sheet metal this or TIG welded that. Just pay a little attention to detail. People will notice. Enough playing around, let's put some of this stuff together.
I gotta earn it. I gotta earn it. I can't behave.
got a little trick for you. Anybody that does braided tubing, you know, installs braided lines on cars, you know, with AN fins and stuff, knows how aggravating these things are. You get all these little pricklies sticking out and you can't get the fitting on there. Got a little trick. Take your hose clamp. A lot of people put tape on these and then cut through the tape. And you can do that. The problem is it gets all sticky and it's not as clean as this trick here. You take your hose clamp and just slide it on the tubing. And then when you cut it, just cut right next to the hose clamp. And it'll be a nice clean cut. Once you get done, just really slowly take off the hose clamp and it won't unfray, and then you can stick it right in the fitting. There you go, you heard it here first. Tech tip. That's all there's to it, then you just cut it. Use a chop saw and just cut it really close to this. It's alright if you grind the hose clamp itself. Alright, there you go, you see that? Nice and clean. I'm gonna take that thing off. See there? No tape. You got a little few little stragglers, but that's pretty normal. Usually it's a lot worse than that, even with tape, so. You just slide your fitting over that and go to work.
If it's free, it won't be worth it. And if it's easy, I don't deserve it. I want it to last, so I gotta earn it.
Alright guys, there you go. That's the fuel system. It's all just mocked up now. I'm gonna take it all apart. I gotta clean it. A lot of times when you cut those, you get all kinds of rubber and stuff in there. So if you're doing a project like this, make sure you clean all those lines, you know, very thoroughly. Otherwise, it's just gonna clog up your system. Still gotta do some minor modifications on the tank. Gonna paint the straps and work on the filler and stuff. But all that should go in soon. And fuel system's done. Check it off the list. Next, gotta finish the wiring. Anyway, that's it for this week. I'll see you guys Friday. Oh, by the way, shirts, killfab.com.